Let's discuss the character of Cassius in the play Julius Caesar. Now, Cassius is an intriguing character. He is Brutus's brother-in-law. And actually, initially, Brutus, who was very close to Caesar initially, he was somewhat reluctant to engage in the conspiracy against Julius Caesar. However, it's Cassius that plays a really important role in basically convincing Brutus to join this conspiracy against Caesar. And of course, they are the men who basically lead in the killing of Julius Caesar at the Senate. Now, he takes part in this conspiracy, but of course, even after, once Mark Antony wishes to speak at Caesar's death, and of course, even don't forget, Cassius did want both Caesar and Mark Antony to be assassinated. However, Brutus did not want that to happen. Now, when Mark Antony wished to speak first at Caesar's funeral, we can see that Cassius is actually a very acute, he has a very acute understanding of human nature. He already sensed that Mark Antony might change things and tip the balance against them, which he does with his very rousing speech. And of course, him and Brutus are forced to flee, and they organize this rebel army in northern Greece. But ultimately, after he mistakenly thinks that Brutus has been killed, he also kills himself by committing suicide rather than be captured by Mark Antony and Octavius's army. Now, when you're writing about Julius Caesar, especially if you have to write about the character of Cassius, I have selected all the key quotations to bear in mind and to memorize either for your coursework or exams when discussing his character. So let's go through them and the word level analysis to do. Now, the first quotation, and of course, this quotation illustrates how Cassius really strongly and firmly believes that Julius Caesar has become far too imperious, far too ambitious, and he's basically a shadow of his former self as a leader, is when he states that Julius Caesar is groaning underneath his age's yoke. Remember, a yoke is basically the thing that's put on the necks of cattle or animals of labor, so beasts of labor in farms. So that's usually that wooden thing that's put on the neck. So anyone that's laboring under a yoke, they're laboring under a burden. Now, what he's saying here, and of course, bear in mind in terms of word level analysis, this is a metaphor. He's basically saying that Julius Caesar, he is no longer fit to be a leader. He is groaning under the weight of his old age, under how the older he's getting, the more and more removed he is from the relevant worries and issues in Roman society. And he really just needs to be kicked out. The second quotation to bear in mind with Cassius's character is when, of course, again, we can see here he's really resentful, especially of how imperious he sees Julius Caesar as being, how arrogant he believes Julius Caesar has become. He states, "This man is now become a god, and Cassius is a wretched creature and must bend his body if Caesar carelessly but not on him." Now here, what he's basically saying is Caesar, you know, is expecting everybody just basically to suck up to him. He, you know, he only can only just needs to look at people and everybody should bow down to him. So he's really, really angry at what he perceives as Caesar's arrogant and imperious nature. But also we can sense that Cassius himself has ambitions for his own power and his increase in power. And he needs Julius Caesar to get out of the way for that to be fulfilled. Now, the word level analysis you want to do here is firstly the two metaphors that Caesar has become a god, and of course also the metaphor of Cassius referring to himself as just a simple normal creature. So in Caesar's eyes, you know, he feels that Caesar looks on him just as, you know, a mere mortal, a creature. Also, you want to focus on the alliteration of bend and body, okay? So the alliteration of the words, of the letters B. And remember that B is the plosive sound, and what this is showing is Cassius is really angry at how he sees Julius Caesar as being so arrogant. The third quotation to bear in mind with Cassius's character is when he states, "A man no mightier than thyself, Ellipsis, yet prodigus grown." So here he's speaking to the other senators, he's speaking to other people in Rome, and he's basically saying, you know, Julius Caesar is no stronger than all of us, but yet he's become too big for his boots. He's become way too arrogant. He thinks he's just way too amazing. Okay, that's basically what he's saying here. And the word level analysis that you can do when you're analyzing this quote is firstly the alliteration of M in man and mightier, and the absence of O in prodigus grown. And prodigus means he's become way too, you know, his head has become too inflated with, you know, delusions of his own grandeur. The other quotation when it comes to Cassius's character is when, of course, he sees killing Julius Caesar as him doing a duty to Rome. And he even tells Brutus and the other men that have conspired, you know, we've actually done a duty to our country and we're going to be remembered in history for all the good things we've done. And of course, this really massive, huge, important act in establishing democracy, because Julius Caesar was going to probably make Rome a dictatorship. And he states, "So often shall the knot of us be called the men that gave the country liberty." Okay, so here he's saying, you know, we're going to be remembered. And of course, here we can also sense his ambition. He wants to be remembered. He wants to be seen as a great leader and as a great ruler. Now, the word level analysis you want to do here is firstly the sibilance of S in so and shall, and also the abstract noun liberty, this idea of him fighting for ideals. However, it's interesting that Cassius, even if he fights with similar ideals to Brutus, who believes in the importance of democracy, we sense that there's a stronger element of ambition within Cassius's ideas, as opposed to Brutus, who genuinely believes in protecting democracy for the greater good of his country. Cassius, we get the sense that he also wants to be remembered in history, in Roman history, as the man that, you know, participated in the killing of Julius Caesar. So there's also an element of ambition on his side, and he's accusing Caesar of the very same things that he harbors within his heart. The other key quotation to bear in mind with Cassius's character is when he and Brutus are arguing. So this is after they've fled and they've created a rebel army, and they're arguing over strategy and things, and Cassius gets really, really angry at Brutus. He states, "There's my dagger, ellipsis, strike as thou didst at Caesar." Okay, so here he's speaking word level analysis wise, and this is a structure technique you can talk about. He's using the imperative sentence strike, and he's basically saying, okay, Brutus, if you don't believe me, if you don't, you know, want to follow what I'm suggesting, you know, here's my chest, here's my bare chest, and here's my dagger, stab me, you might as well kill me, okay, I'm fed up of this. And of course, here we can see that he's very, very theatrical. There's obviously a lot of tension at times between him and Brutus, and but usually he ultimately follows what Brutus suggests. The other quotation to bear in mind is now when he feels that the end is nigh. So they've raised this rebel army, but he's sensing that the end is near, and he states, "Ravens, crows, and kites fly over our heads and downward look on us as we were sickly prey." Now here, he uses, or rather Shakespeare uses the rule of three to describe creatures such as ravens, crows, and kites. And of course, these birds tend to be ominous birds. They tend to symbolize bad omens, bad luck. And what he's basically saying is that he's sensing that they are going to lose, and that his end is near, he's going to die. And what they were hoping for Rome, and what they were hoping in terms of establishing their leadership and leading Rome in the right direction, both Brutus and Cassius, that's not going to happen. Also, the other key word level analysis to do is, of course, the simile, as we were sickly prey. So he's basically saying that these ominous birds are looking at Brutus, Cassius, and his army as basically prey, which is going to be destroyed very soon. The final quotation when it comes to Cassius's character is when he eventually decides to commit suicide. He's mistakenly believed that Brutus and Titinus have basically died, and so he doesn't want to be a prisoner and imprisoned by Mark Antony and Octavius. So he decides to commit suicide, and he states, "Where I did begin, there I shall end. My life has run his compass." Okay, now here, of course, this is him deciding that his life has run its course. He is now going to commit suicide. The word level analysis you want to do here is firstly the oxymoron, the opposite words of begin and end. And of course, the other word level analysis you want to do is the metaphor compass, this idea that his life has now run its course. So that's it when it comes to the key quotations to bear in mind when writing about or discussing the character of Cassius.